Casey. So, failed payouts are exactly what they sound like. Payouts that didn't make it to your bank account. You'll know if a payout has failed if the status section of a particular payout says failed. When your payout fails, you'll be sent an email and a notification will appear on your admin. Most importantly, a hold will be placed on your future payouts until the issue is resolved. Don't worry, your money isn't going anywhere. Shopify is just holding onto it for you until the problem is fixed. But there's a few reasons this might happen, and a few things that you can check to get that cash into your account quickly. The first is incorrect bank account information. Maybe you skipped a number in your bank account or input the wrong routing number. If this happens, the bank will send a message saying the account either doesn't exist or is closed. To resolve this, update your banking information with the correct details and then retry the payout. All right, next, there might be an account currency mismatch. What this means is your bank account might not support the currency the payout is in. Let's say you're in Canada and have your payout set up to be in USD. If you don't have a USD account that's based in Canada, the payout will fail. To fix this, make sure your payouts are set to a currency that your bank account supports. It could also be that you have an invalid account type. Depending on your region, your bank account will have to meet specific requirements in order to be connected to Shopify Payments. For example, savings accounts and virtual bank accounts aren't supported account types. Check the link below to see what the banking requirements are in your region. If you've got your Shopify Payments connected to an unsupported account type, update it to one that is. Moving on, it might be that you have an incorrect beneficiary or payee name. Fancy words, I know, but this one's important. The payee name for your payout should be the same as the one on your bank account. If these don't match, the bank might reject the payout. For example, if the bank account is registered to Muhammad, the payee name needs to be Muhammad too. If the bank account is under Muhammad, but the payee is listed as Omar, that payout is going to fail. Update your bank account details with Shopify Payments to avoid another failed payout. Last but not least, you might not have enough funds to cover a negative payout. Why would I have a negative payout, you might be wondering? Well, a negative payout can occur when you have to refund an order, but don't have enough funds in your Shopify payouts balance to cover it. Let's say your customer Priya requests a refund on her order that cost $150, but you only have $100 in your payouts balance. You'll be able to refund Priya her full amount, but you'll have negative $50 in your account. This negative $50 will show up as a failed payout. If this happens, there are two different outcomes depending on where you live. Either the balance is debited from your bank account on the day of the payout, or the remainder of the refund is deducted from the next payout until the refunded amount is covered. Once the full refund amount is covered, you'll receive your money. And there you have it. A few reasons why your payout may have failed and what you can do to fix it. If your payout is still failing after watching this video, visit the Shopify Help Center at help.shopify.com.